Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to this edition of Programming Wizards. Now today once more we shall look at something quite interesting. We're going to see first how to add items from our JText field to our database. Okay, then we shall also see how to retrieve those items. We shall also see how to update items, okay, in our database, okay, and show them in our, of course, our J combo box. Then we shall also see how to delete each item. We shall also see how to clear our J combo box. I mean, now guys, this is what I'm talking about. Let's try. Now, for instance, let's say that I want to add. I come right here. I click add, successfully inserted. Actually, it has also inserted into the database, not just in our combo box. Now, you see, it's selecting, it's inserting. Like I come here, add another one, inserting. It is inserting and programmatically selecting that item that we've just inserted. Then what about if I want to update? I come here, click update. I come here, like type something like this one. Let me type something like this one. Then click update. Successfully updated. It updates it. Then refreshes the combo box and then shows right here. What about if I want to delete? I come here, select one, then it deletes it. Okay, you can see it's no longer there. I also delete this one right here. Actually, I can also clear. If I clear, we just clear them from the combo box, but not from the database. If you want to also remove, if you click retrieve, it retrieves them. If you want to remove them from the database, we shall have to delete them. Okay, now guys, that's it. This is what we're going to look at. So welcome, we get started. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm using my SQL server. Okay, I'm using WOMP server right here. You can see my PHP, my admin. This is my database. Actually, it is this one, this second column that we shall be dealing with. You can see the first item right there is the same item right here. Take note of the last item right here. If we come to our combo box, it's the last item. So actually the changes that we were making were being persisted. Now guys, if you want to use also MySQL, of course you can use WAMP server or MySQL server. Now if you're using WAMP server, now just come to your PHP MyAdmin, then create your database using here. Then once you've created the database, just come here and create the tables, create the field that you want to do. Okay, that's it. So ladies and gentlemen, the first step after that one, now the first time after you've created your database, now you can just come and design your form. There is no big deal about it. You can see I've already designed my form right here. This is just a combo box. Of course, I've put it inside my panel, blue panel. Now I have here a JText field. It is here that we shall be typing. The user shall be typing data. Then when he clicks add, we add to the database. When he click retrieve, we retrieve data from the database and fill our J combo box. When he clicks update, we update what he has typed right here with what is in the. We update our database with what he has typed right here. When we click delete, we delete what he has selected. When we click clear, we clear the J combo box without affecting the database. When he selects an item right here, we set that selected item to a J text field. No, that's it. The first step, please just come to your project. Now here is my project. Let me just close these ones. Now my project is this combo box stuff. So the one just come here and then in your libraries, just right click it, then click add library. Then from the library, just start typing there MySQL. It shall bring you to this MySQL JDBC driver. Actually, fortunately for us, if you're using NetBeans, the driver will come automatically. If you're using Eclipse, please just go to the MySQL website and download MySQL connector. Okay, download the MySQL connector JDBC driver from MySQL website. Now this is it. Just click this one, add library. That's all that you need. You shall need for your connection. Okay. Now once you've done that one, just come. This is, of course, is our GUI class. You can see it's empty. You can just double click your various buttons just to create for us events that we're going to handle. Otherwise, it's empty. No, our plan for today will be that we shall have two classes, the GUI class, which shall be specifically for GUI stuff, and then the database class that shall be for database, specifically for database. So all the heavy work, the database stuff, we shall do in our DB class. Now when we come to GUI, our GUI class, we shall do a very simple stuff. We shall just be calling the various methods from our database class. So let's get started, guys. Enough talking. Now the first thing that we shall need, this is my SQL, of course. So we shall need a connection string. So let's just create a string, a variable to hold our connection string. So just say string const string. Then right there we are going to have our connection string. So you can see, like for me, my JDBC, my SQL, localhost, which is my server, then port 3306. So by default, my SQL uses 3306 as its port. Unless you've changed it, you'll just have to specify 3306. Then my but if you've changed it, please specify here the port here that you've changed. Now my this is my database name, so you also specify there your database name. We shall also need username. Now for username, by default MySQL uses root as the username. If you've created a new username, you can use it there. Then password. Now by default it's normally empty. My database has no password. If you specified a password for your database, you shall have to specify it right there. That's it. Those are the global variables that we shall need for our connection. Now the first thing, we shall jump straight, let's create a public method which shall return a boolean. Let's call the method add. Now in the method, let's pass a parameter name. So actually, in short, this name is what the user shall be typing in our text field. So we are giving it public because we shall want to call it from the GUI class. But it shall return a boolean just to show us if the connection, if the insertion has been successful or not. So we shall just be returning a boolean, false or true. Now guys, the first thing that we shall need to create our SQL statement for inserting. So come here and say SQL statement, then string, I'll call it SQL equal to insert into plus TB table values name. Okay, the thing is simple. What we're doing, we're inserting into actually this is our plus TB. Take note, this is plus TB, this is plus DB. So this is the plus table, actually our table name. Then we're passing it in the column name. This is the column that we shall be updating. Then values shall be the name, whatever shall be typed right here. Remember, if you want to know how to update a multi-column, if you want to know how to update multiple columns at the same time, we have a tutorial about JTable with MySQL database. We explained all those ones comprehensively. So you can just scroll through our channel and see. Now that's it. The first thing that we're going to do, we're going to come and create a try catch block right here, where we're going to, first we're going to deal with our connection. We have to get our connection. Now just come and say we're going to use the connection class. I don't know what's going on here. So just come here and say connection con equal to driver manager. Whoa, what am I typing today? So this is driver manager, this is connection. I'll have to look better at this, my caps. Now connection con equal to driver manager dot get connection. Then right there we shall have to pass three parameters. We shall have to pass three parameters. The first parameter shall be our connection string, so pass their connection string. The second one shall be our username, and the last one shall be the password. Those shall be the parameters that we shall need. Actually, here let's just come and handle this one. Let's just come here and catch exception, SQL exception. I'll call it ex. Then once we come here, we shall just x dot print stack trace. That's it. Now all our errors should be gone. Then I come and format it to make it look better. Okay, now the next thing that we shall need is the statement. So for a statement, just come and say statement. We shall use the statement class as equal to con dot prepare statement. Now for the prepare statement, we shall pass in our SQL statement, and that shall give us our statement object. Then now the only thing that we have to do is to execute. So just come here and say execute. Now say s dot execute. So we call the execute, we pass the SQL statement as our parameter. Then that's it. Of course, in this case, we shall return true because it shall have been successful. But in case we have an error, we are going to come right here and then just pass false. Actually, this one, we shall be passing a boolean. In our GUI class, we shall determine if it is true. We shall tell the user that he has successfully inserted. If it is false, we shall tell him that he is not been fortunate to insert. Now that's it. That's our insertion method. Now the next thing we're going to come is to retrieve. For retrieving once more, let me just minimize this one. For retrieving once more, we're going to create a method, public void. We'll just call it retrieve. It shall take nothing, it shall return nothing. So the first thing that we shall need with this method, actually it won't return nothing. It will have to return something. What we shall return is the default combo box model. So just come and say default combo box model. That's what we shall return. The reason why we are going to return it is very simple. Once we've returned its object, we shall just set it as the model for our combo box, and that shall be it. We don't want to do any database operation, okay, in our GUI class. So the first thing, what we're going to do, we're just going to instantiate it. So just come here and say default combo box model DM equal to new default combo box model. Okay, and that shall give us our DM object that we shall use. Now this one should not be here. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, once more, the first thing that we shall do is we shall deal with our SQL statement. So come and say string SQL equal to select name from place TB. We're only selecting that one column that we want to display in our combo box. So we shall also have our try catch block right here, and then I shall just copy paste this exception. It's what we shall need, and then we close this one once more. So we shall come here, try catch block, then once more right here we're going to, this one should not be here. What we're going to need, this should be catch. The first thing that we're going to need our connection object. So we're going to create our connection object, con equal to driver manager dot get connection. Then we shall pass three parameters. The first one is the con string, then the second one is the username, and then the lastly, of course, is the password. That shall give us our connection object, which we shall use to create our statement. Now for statement, I just say statement s equal to con dot prepare statement, con dot prepare statement. Then right there, this should be prepare statement. We pass, of course, our SQL statement. Once we've done so, remember this is a retrieval, so we shall need to store our data in a result set. So let's create the result set object. Just say s dot execute query, then we pass there our SQL statement. Now that one shall return for us the data that we shall store in our result set. Once we've done so, we shall want to loop through that data and add it to our default combo box model object. So we shall come here and say loop through that one. Now we shall have a while, we shall use a while loop. So just say while rs.next. Now that is it. This one shall help us loop through our result set. So what we're going to do, as we shall be looping through, we shall be getting the value, that is the from that name column, and adding it to our DM object, default combo box model object. So just say a string, I'll call it name equal to rs.getString. Now right there we shall pass the column index. For us we shall be, it's just one, so we shall just pass it that one. So after that one we're going to add it to our model. Okay, so just say dm.addElement, then we pass there the name that we just added right there. Now ladies and gentlemen, it's that simple. Once we've done so, we just come and make sure that we return our DM object, default combo box model object. We return it if that has been successful. If it hasn't, we shall just return null. So come here and say return null, and that's it. Now that's our retrieval method. It shall retrieve for us data, then return the model. Now once we've done so, we shall just straight away proceed with the update. Okay, we shall see how to update. Once more, we shall create a method, public void. No, it shall also return boolean, so as to inform the user whether it has been successful or not. Update. Then for our update, of course, we shall need the ID to identify the row to be updated, and then we shall also need the value. Now that is the new value. So in short, for us, we shall just use the old value as the ID just to identify the row, then the new value of the value we shall use, of course, as the new value, just to set it as now the new value. So once more, we shall create our SQL statement, string SQL equal to update place tb set name. Now name, name, this one should be value. We are going to set it to the, so this one should be the new value, where name equal to ID. So we are going to use the name as our ID, okay, the old value. Okay, so name equal to name is equal to the ID. So now the old value, just as I've said, shall be is what we shall use to identify the row to be updated. Okay, remember we're dealing only with one column right here. Actually, had we been dealing with a lot of columns, would have just used the ID column, but we're using the one column, so we shall use the old value as the ID to identify that row, then we set its new value right there. That's it. The next thing we're going to do, of course, is our try catch block. We create the try catch block, and then I copy paste this piece of catch right here instead of retyping it. Now I bring it right there. So we shall catch our exception. Then if it's not right, then we shall return false. Now here once more, the first thing that you shall need is our connection object. So say con equal to driver manager dot get connection. This one shall give us the connection. We pass in our three parameters. First con string, then secondary username, and then lastly the password. That's it. That shall give us the connection object, which we shall use to assign to our to create our statement and assign it to our statement object. So say con dot prepare statement. We shall use our connection object to prepare our statement. Of course, we shall pass the SQL statement right there. Then once we've done that one, once we've created our statement object, the only thing now we need to do is to execute. So just come and say s dot execute. Then we pass the SQL statement right there. this should be returning a boolean, so we shall just make sure that we return true right here, so as to notify the user that it has been successful. That's it. That's how easy the update is. Now the next thing we're coming to do is the delete. Now for the delete, you're going to say public. All of them shall be public because we shall want to call them from a foreign class. Now come and say public. This one should be delete here. We shall also return a boolean. Now we shall just here need only the identifier, the ID, to identify the row to be updated, the row to be deleted. So once more we shall create our SQL statement, just here, and assign it to a variable SQL equal to delete from place TB, where name equal to ID. Once more we shall use the name as our identifier, just to so that it identifies for us the row to delete. Now once we've done so, we shall come once more and do this one inside the try catch block, of which we shall get our connection, and then we shall also need to catch that particular exception if we have any. So I'll come here and catch my exception right there. So for our connection, we're just going to create connection object, connection con equal to driver manager dot get connection, of which you shall pass three parameters. Okay, now of course the first parameter shall be the connection string, the second one shall be our username, or the last one shall be the password. Once we've done so, we are going to create our statement object, statement s equal to con dot prepare statement, then we pass the SQL statement over there. Once we've done so, we're going to just execute it. There's nothing more. Execute it. So call execute, we pass over there the SQL statement, then we shall return a true, just to notify the user that we've successfully deleted data. So guys, that's it. That's how we update, that's how we delete our stuff. Okay, we've also seen how to update, how to retrieve, and how to insert. So what that's we are through with our DB class. Now the only thing remaining, we shall now come to our main class. Inside our main class, the first thing that we shall want to do, we shall want to create a private method just to retrieve for us. Now say private avoid, this method shall be responsible for retrieving data. Now retrieve here, what we're going to see, please just remember that the retrieve method here was supposed to return a default combo box model, so that shall make it super easy for us just to add that particular data to a J combo box. So we'll just create an instance default combo box model DM equal to, then we create the instance of our DB class, then we use it to call our get data method, which should return for us default combo box model object. So get data. Now once we have that one, then what is it right here, get data, this one, I hope I made it public. No, I called it retrieve. So let's just come here and say retrieve. Okay, once we have that object, is easy, we just now come and say j combo box one dot set, we set that DM to our as our model, and that's it. Now we just come here and call our retrieve method, so that shall retrieve data for us and fill for us our j combo box. In short, it shall link our j combo box to our database, our MySQL database. Now the next thing is adding. Now for adding, remember adding should return a boolean, so we're still going to create a instance of our DB class. Then once we have that the instance, we're now going to call our add method, which expects one parameter actually, which is the data to be added. For us, that is simple. It's just name dot get text. Then we pass that particular data right there. This is an if else statement. So if that is the case, if it is true, because this one, remember, should be returning a boolean. So if it is true, we're just going to display a message box. Say successfully inserted. Then we're going to call the retrieve method just to refresh our J combo box so that the user can see changes instantly. Then after that one, another thing that I just decided to do, we're just going to select the added item programmatically, select it. The item that has just been added, the latest item to be added, we shall want to select it in our J combo box. So to do that one, just come and say J combo box one dot set selected item. Now the selected item shall be that our new item, the item that has just been added. In our case, it shall be the name. No, just say name txt dot get text. So we shall select it so that the user can see that of course it has been added. Then lastly, we shall just need to clear all our text boxes. No, it's just one anyway. So we just clear it. And then if there's something wrong, if it has not been successfully inserted, maybe the connection is close or something, we'll just display and tell him not inserted. Now ladies and gentlemen, this is our add method. Okay, of course we've also through with our retrieve method. Now we come to our update method. It's just the same process actually. Just copy paste this one. The only thing, we're only going to change a few things right there. So for our update, once more we shall do it inside our if else statement. Then this one change to update. Now the update shall expect two parameters. First, it shall expect the ID. Okay, the ID and also the new value. Now let's just come here as a global variable. Let's just come here and create our ID. So the ID, as I had said, it is what shall be used to identify a particular row that we need to either update or delete. So the way we shall be setting our ID, come to your combo box, come to the event section, come to item state change. Just click the item state change, shall bring us right here. So this event shall be normally be raised when the user selects a new item in a combo box. So what we're going to do first, when the user selects an item, we're going to set that ID, the value of that ID. We're just going to say J combo box one dot get selected item. Then we convert it to string. That shall act as our ID. Remember, this is what the user will have selected. And then we are going to set it to our name txt. J text field. So just set it name txt dot set text. Then we pass it there the ID. So in short, when the user selects something from this combo box, we shall be setting it right here, and that's it. Then it shall also give us the ID. Now the ID, we shall of course just come and use it right there. But now take note that this, the ID actually will be the old value, the value that the user has selected before he has updated this stuff. Now when he wants to update, he shall type something in the name txt. Whatever he types, we take it and set it as the new value. Then right here we just tell him successfully updated. If it has not been successful, we also set it not updated. Then of course we set the selected item to whatever the user has just typed. Please don't pass the ID right here, because the ID will have been replaced by the new value. Then we clear our text field. That's it. That's for our update. Now we come to the delete. Delete is also the same concept. We just pass in the delete. Okay. Now remember, the delete shall expect us to pass the ID. Please don't pass here the name txt, because the name txt, the user can change it. We want something that is in the database. So we shall pass there the ID. Then here we tell him successfully deleted here, not deleted, and that's it. I will clear our text field, then we set it to whatever we set. In fact, this one, let's remove this one right here. This is deleting, so we just please just remove it right there, okay? Because after we shall have deleted the item, so it will no longer be there. So guys, this is how we delete. That's how we delete our stuff. Now for clearing, we shall just want to clear the QG combo box, not the database. The database, of course, we shall be deleting value by value. So to clear the J combo box, just come and say J combo box one dot set model. Then for our model, we're just going to set the instance, a new instance of the default table model, default not table model, default combo box model. We just pass its new instance right there. Of course, it shall be empty, so it shall also set our J combo box to empty. This does it. Does it? I think everything should be fine. Now just press Shift F6 to run your program, so that we have a look. It has been such a quite a long tutorial. So right here we have our program. You can see it right here. Now if I click retrieve, you can see actually my warm server is running, so you can see the data gets retrieved very well. It links our combo box to our database and fetches the data. What if we want to update? Now if we want to update, let me just enlarge in this one. If we want to update, let me say for instance, I come here, type my own stuff right here, then click update. Successfully updated. It updates it, and just what I was telling you, it will programmatically select whatever has been updated. You can see it right here, okay? So you can see it can also update. Now what about if you want to delete, like I come, no, actually there is something that, okay, yeah, you come, we select whatever we want to delete. You can see the data gets set right here. If I come click delete, the data gets deleted. If I want to insert, I come here, click, type data right there, then successfully inserted, and then it selects it right here. If I want to delete it, it just come here, it deletes it. It's no longer in the database, okay? In fact, even if we retrieve again, you can see it's no longer right there. So guys, that's it. If we clear, everything gets cleared. If we retrieve, it will retrieve. Guys, that's it. Hope you've enjoyed the tutorial, if it has been such quite a long one. So please, if you have, just leave a comment down below. We'd like to hear from you guys. You can even say hi, okay? There's no problem with that one. You can like this video. Please share it with friends and family. And please just subscribe to this channel so that you continue receiving tutorials like these ones on a regular basis. Guys, take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.